For hosting this event. I'm very proud to be delivering my first State of the City speech in such a warm, friendly venue, surrounded by a community of friends, family, and business owners. Thank you, Jerry. Thank you, Sean. Yes, ma'am. Okay. You think with four teenagers, I wouldn't need more volume. All right, good. So, what is the State of the City of Chelsea, Michigan? In the fall of 2010. Well, our city is certainly not immune to the financial concerns that have plagued our state and national economies. Despite declining property values and state shared revenues, our city has looked inward to manage costs and still provide essential city services without a general fund tax increase in the last 3 years. This is a remarkable feat. The balance in the general fund is within the city's stated policy guidelines of between 15 and 20% of the general fund operating budget. The fund balance for the fiscal year June 30th, 2010 is approximately 39.2% of the actual general fund expenditures. In fact, the fund balance is at its best shape in the history of our local government. Just 5 years ago, this fund balance barely hovered above $100,000. Today, it is a healthy $1.4 million. Our administrative team, including City Manager John Hanifan and Administrative Director Kim Garland, has done a magnificent job, especially in this difficult economic climate. This can be attributed to better management of individual department budgets, greater than anticipated state shared revenues, a reduction in the full-time workforce, and a reduction of the anticipated spending of capital improvements within the various city departments. Even though we are experiencing difficult times, the city continues to provide essential services for the quality of life issues that directly impact our citizens and shape our community. The Chelsea Senior Center, the Wave Transportation System, and the Chelsea Recreation Council are but just a few that come to mind. Additionally, the Community Garden Project is a superb example of the reach and impact that our city has on its residents. Working together, the city provided the land asset, Faith in Action provided the administrative guidance, our residents provided the labor of love, and the land gave back the produce that in many cases was donated back to Faith in Action, allowing them to enhance their mission of feeding our most vulnerable population, children. This is Chelsea today. The merger of the St. Joseph Mercy Hospital System and Chelsea Community Hospital has proven to be a very good thing for our community. An infusion of capital from the St. Joseph System will not only give us a state-of-the-art facility in our own backyard, but also create jobs and opportunities for families and businesses alike. Another result of the merger was the formation of the Chelsea Area Wellness Foundation. St. Joseph Mercy endowed $25 million to this foundation. The primary purpose of the foundation is to support significant Chelsea Community Hospital initiatives and local health improvement initiatives through grants. Silver Maples was a recent recipient of one of these grants for your Home, Move, and Groove project. This three-loop walking trail will connect the Silver Maples campus with the Chelsea Community Hospital, the Chelsea Schools, St. Mary Parish, and the City Sidewalk Network. Creating a culture of healthy living and linking community partners is smart, informed, and very forward-thinking. This is Chelsea today. Chelsea Milling, also known as Jiffy Mix, continues to boom and thrive in our city. The company is expanding its capacity by building 6 new silos beginning next month. They've recently upgraded their research and development facilities and renovated their welcome center. We're proud to have the Jiffy plant here in Chelsea. Their continued investments ensure a thriving business which is vital to our community, our community's growth and sustainability. Jiffy is Chelsea. With a solid infrastructure in place, the Chelsea First marketing campaign was launched as a joint partnership between the city, the DDA, the Chamber of Commerce, and concerned business leaders to develop a comprehensive marketing and branding campaign. The goal of this campaign initiative is to increase the number of customers from the local trade area as well as the greater regional market. We want to position Chelsea as a leading choice for visitors, businesses, and residents seeking to relocate. Last month, the city hosted representatives from Dexter, Manchester, Grass Lake, Pinckney, and Eastern Jackson County for a training session called Balancing Nature and Commerce. This combined effort seeks to create partnerships in the surrounding Waterloo-Pinckney recreation areas to promote our region as a destination. Right out our front door is one of the largest state recreation lands, and Chelsea and its partners are positioning themselves as the gateway to communities to these treasured land assets. This is yet another example of our community leaders thinking proactively and collaboratively. 2 years ago, the city began construction of the largest public works project in the city's history, the $11.7 million expansion of a wastewater treatment plant. Under the supervision of Utilities Director Brad Roberts, the project was completed in May of 2010, on time and under budget. Let me say that again, on time and under budget. Without the plant expansion, there would not be any possibility for future economic growth, including redevelopment and infill projects. The city was able to secure a coveted state revolving loan to finance the project at a 2% interest rate. Wow. To quote a famous TV personality, this is a good thing. The city continues to move forward with the police station project. Under Chief Ed Toth's leadership, our officers have faithfully protected and served our community despite cramped and outdated quarters. For too long, our officers have made do without excuse or complaint. This new station will modernize the department and provide a 50-year solution to a 20-year challenge. The city held 2 important town hall meetings on this problem that were well attended by concerned citizens. And in the true manner that makes this city great, thoughtful and passionate opinions were offered. The direct input of our citizens is critical to the progress of our community, and this evening I can report to you that your viewpoints were heard, were appreciated, and were acted upon. The project is scheduled to break ground in the spring of 2011. Lastly, the city continues to update and upgrade its information technology infrastructure to enhance efficiency and to promote greater transparency. Utility customers can now go online to view their utility statements at home or at a city-provided public kiosk. City Council meetings are now professionally broadcast on Channel 18. Those missing town hall meetings can tune in and watch the rebroadcast and be up to speed on key city happenings. The city also produced a concise yet thorough video on the wastewater treatment plant expansion that is available for viewing on the city website and is also being broadcast on Channel 18. The city will continue to use this format to inform its residents and businesses of all that is happening in this great city. And so, my friends, what defines a community? I know some communities are defined by their illustrious history. For others, it is their public school system. A few communities I've visited have a real commitment to their senior population and to their arts and culture population. And many communities are known for their quaint downtowns and retail spaces. Lucky for us, Chelsea is known for all of these things and so much more. As a fourth generation resident, I feel like I have had a front row seat and watching my hometown grow in a sustained, focused way that makes me so very proud to represent you as mayor. We are a modern, unique, thriving Midwestern community. In closing, we are doing our utmost to put Chelsea first. That's a simple yet powerful idea that is gaining ground. I'm fortunate enough as mayor to meet and interact with virtually every segment of our population in town. We don't always agree. We can view the same issue or challenge with diametrically opposed vantage points. However, that simple phrase unites us as a community. Together, we are laying a foundation that will make Chelsea stronger and more vital for generations to come. Thank you for being here this evening and for honoring me with your presence.